Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. This is episode 2 of the Bucket coding tutorial. So today in episode 2, we're going to be going over event handlers and how to register events. So if you didn't watch episode 1 on how to set up, go check that out. Link will be in the description below, or actually you can just go look at my channel. And so today we're going to start by creating a new project, and we'll call it episode 2. Event handlers. Alright. So let's drag that in here. Okay. So first, we want to set up our build path. Add external jars. And let's begin 1.12.2. Alright. So we'll create a new package. Like we did last time. We need a bravepanda.eventhandlers. And we'll create our main class. So, if you remember last time, we did just the, we did the regular, just plain old on enable and off disable, or on enable and on disable. So we're gonna set that up now. So we have our public void on enable. Just ignore that Norton thing. And public void on disable. Go away. Alright, so on our on enable, we're gonna do a little thing that basically tells our console that the plugin has been loaded and that the plugin has been unloaded. So we're gonna go up here. We're going to create a new variable called console command sender console equals this dot, dude, go away, this dot get server then console sender. Now, if we just import this, we have our console. So now we can do console.sendMessage, and we can say events plugin enabled, and we can copy this and paste it down here and say disabled. So now whenever onEnable is called, it'll send the message to console saying the events plugin has been enabled. And when it's disabled, it will say the events plugin has been disabled. Now, if we want to add chat color to ours, we can do two different ways to do it. We can do the fancy color symbol, which is Alt 2 1. And that will do that. Or we could do chat color dot green. And you want to do the org.bucket.chatColor. So now it will say in green, events plugin enabled. And just to show you that this way works too, but it is better to use chatColor just in case of any problems or anything. It's better to use the little color sign. And we'll do C for red. So now, if we do our plugin.yml, event handlers, and we'll call this events plugin. So now, if we just export this, slash event handlers, and we reload our server, you'll see events plugin enabled, and if we reload it again, you'll see events plugin disabled. Now they both work, but again, both of the colors, yeah, they do work. So it doesn't matter which one you use, as long as one of them works. Alright, like, froze on me. Alright, So now let's go over what this event, or what this tutorial is really about today, and that's event handlers. So whenever you have an event class, you always want it to implement listener. And this basically says, alright, we're going to be listening for an event. So whenever you have a class, and when we go over multiple classes, we'll go into this further, but we want to make sure it implements listener. And we do, we always start an event handler with at event handler. And then we do public void. And we'll call it on, what event do we want to do? Let's do when player right click, or when player, yeah, right clicks. On, actually, let's do on chat. Sorry, I can't make up my mind here. We'll do on join. Sorry, on join player join event E. So basically, I'll explain what's going on here. So this is the basic setup for a event handler. You have the event handler, you have the public void, you have its name, so this one is onJoin. You have the event here, and then you assign that event a variable. So it could be event, it could be E, it could be P, it could be D, but we usually use E or event. So now that we have that, we can get the player who did the event. So we could do player P, because we want a player variable, player P, equals e.getPlayer. So now this returns the player who joined. And we can do p.sendMessage. Welcome to my server. So now that we have that, whenever we have a plugin, we need to register the events. So now this event is already finished, so we're going to do, this is how you register event. You only register your events in the on enable. So you do this dot get server dot get plugin manager dot register events, this and this. So what this is, it's the method that says at the server, at the plugin manager, you want to register an event. Now if you hover over it, it says it takes a listener and a plugin. So the listener, in this example, remember we have the listener up here, is this, because it's this instance of the class. And then the plugin is this, because we have Java plugin. So we do this. Now if I export it, and reload the server, and then I join the server, it should say, welcome to my server. Don't mind this big crater. It says, welcome to my server. Now, if we want to make it a little more customizable, we could do welcome to my server, comma, space, p, oh, plus, p dot get name. So now it says welcome to my server plus the player name. So if we export this plugin, we reload, disconnect, and then we connect again, it says welcome to my server, whatever your name is. So that's another way of doing it. And so there's thousands of events. If we look at the Java docs, hub.spaghettimc, if we look at the Java docs and look at event, first of all, there's all these different types of events. But if we do player events, we can see there's so many events. So let's pick one here. We can do let's do player interact events. So remember how we did, if the player clicks on a block, we want to do player, if a player clicks on a grass block, if they right click on a grass block, or if they left click on a grass block and try to break glass, if they try to break grass, we'll make sure that it can't. So what we do is we create another event handler, and we call this public void on break player. Actually, instead of doing the interact event, we could do player block break event, I believe it is. Player. Is it? I think it's just block break event. Block break event E. Let's see if that works. Yep, block break event. Okay, so first we're gonna assign who we're gonna get the player variable again. So we're gonna do player p equals e dot get player, and then we're gonna do block b equals e dot get block. So now what we're doing is we're getting the player who broke the block, and we're getting the block that was broken. So then we're gonna do an if statement. So if b dot get type, so if the block type is equal to material dot grass, and you're gonna do this. So basically it says if the block type is grass, do this. So first we'll send a message to the player. So we'll use that chat color again. Don't break, you can't break that block player. And then we're going to do e.set canceled, true. So now what we're going to do is, if it's grass block, we're going to set the canceled to true. So we're going to make sure that that block is never actually broken. So if we reload, we try to break grass, it says you can't break that block player. Let me just turn down my game sound a little bit. But now if you try to break it, any grass block, it says you can't break that block player. But if I break stone, it works. If I break dirt, it works. But if I try to do grass, it says you can't break it because we are setting it canceled. So now, that's basically, now you know how to use events. And now you know how to register events in this. So all the events are all here. There's more player events, like player bucket fill event. So what we could do is, let's do another example. Public void. So we're creating another event handler on fill player. Bucket fill event E. Import that. So we're gonna again create the player variable equals E dot get player. Then we're gonna say if E dot get bucket dot actually, we're not even going to do that. We're just going to set it to cancel again. E.setCanceled, true. So remember, we're setting it canceled. And we're going to send the message to a player saying, again, using checkColor.red, plus you aren't allowed to fill buckets. Now, if we export it and reload, can now see that if we try to fill a bucket, so if I get a bucket out, and is there a water source nearby? Yep, one right here. If I try to fill a bucket, it says you aren't allowed to fill buckets. Now we'd eventually need to fix it so it replaces the water, because as you can see, it just removes the water. But again, we could fix that another time. But your bucket is still not getting filled, and that's the purpose, or the point. So, again, this is the basic setup for a event handler. So again, it's add event handler, public void, the name of the event handler, and then in these parentheses, the name of the event, and then the variable you want to assign. Now, there's a couple things that you have to be careful of. For example, if we do an entity event, Or entity, we'll do entity damage, entity event. So we do event handler public void on attack entity damage entity event, I believe it is. So basically this is the no, it is entity damage by entity event. And basically this is called whenever an entity damages an entity. What you have to be careful is if you look, you can't do e.getPlayer. It won't let you do that. So what you have to do is first you want to check if it was a player. So if e.get entity, so the entity that is being damaged, instance of player, then do that. So it's saying if it is an instance of the player, so if the entity that's getting damaged is a player, continue. And then we can do if e.get, or so then what we can do is then we can do player p equals e.get entity, and then we're going to have to cast it as a player. So it's basically saying I know that the entity could be any type of entity, but this time we're setting it as a player. And then what we're going to do is, actually, we don't even have to worry about that. And then we can do p.setCancelled, or e, sorry, e.setCancelled true. And we can send a message to the player saying chat caller type, let's say green plus. Oh, I made a mistake. I meant to say if e.get damager, because we want to get the entity that damaged the player. Get damager. Oh, because we're not getting the entity that's damaged. We're getting the entity that's being that did the damage. So then we can write you hit a plus e.get entity dot get type, I believe. So now if we export it, reload, and if I go try to hit a sheep, it says you hit a sheep, you hit a sheep. And if I spawn a creeper, it says you hit a creeper. If I spawn a Enderman or Endermite, says you hit an Endermite. And look, if you look, I'm not doing any damage to them. So these are good for events, are very good for hub plugins. So if you're going to create a hub plugin for someone, for example, say you don't want players to, again, break blocks, instead of putting if b.getType uses material.grass, you just delete that line of code. These events are very good for different things, but I would say they're very useful for hub plugins. So if you're looking to create your first plugin, create a simple hub plugin. That's what I did. I did one called Hub Essentials, I think. It doesn't allow a player to talk. It doesn't allow a player to pick up items. It doesn't allow a player to hit other players, break blocks, all these things. And that's what you can do with events. Events are very unlimited. There's so many events out there. So go explore the events. I'll put a link to the Java docs below where you can look at all the event types. And so if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe, and comment. And I will see you in the next episode where we most likely discuss commands. So if you have any suggestions, leave them below. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.